Good morning, students. So welcome to eTaragati, Education Digitalized. And today we shall be beginning a new month with a new day, which is the 1st September 2020. And Eroja Kavalsan daily Hindu newspaper analysis, we shall take it up now. So this newspaper analysis, as most of you are aware, we focus on basically Group 1, Group 2, UPSC, and other competitive examinations. So, and since we take up a very analytical discussion apart from the factual analysis, the discussion would be useful even for other competitive examinations like banking examinations, kani like with the UPSC pete other examinations like CAPF, CDS, where there is a lot of scope of current affairs. So basically, newspaper nunchi evaithe oka examination point of view lo pertinent ga adagadam jarugutundo. Adanta meeku ee course lo we shall cover. So at the onset, I would request you to please like, share and subscribe the video if you like it. And also take part actively in the mains answer writing, which we are providing with this video. So at the end of the video, we are also providing you with mains answer writing. And this is extremely useful to increase your speed, and especially people who are giving Group 1 this year. Edithe November lo undo, there is hardly 2 months left, and you should be very comfortable with answer writing by now. And please take note that the news which is generally asked in the examinations, APPSC examinations, have last 3-4 months nunchi maximum news vastayi current affairs related. So if chese man newspaper analysis would have a direct impact on your preparation, and make full use of it in that way. All right. So let us begin with today's first page. The headlines basically is PLA aggression blocked at Pangong So. So as we have been seeing since the last few days, near the area of Ladakh, itete Jammu and Kashmir state unno India di. Near LAC. LAC is the line of actual control in the Aksai Chin region. And this is India, Jammu and Kashmir. Right? So this LAC was basically drawn as part of the, you know, current boundary between India and China. And it is illegally occupied by China. That is India's position. So ikkada Pangong So Lake edaithe undo. There is PLA aggression. All right, here we have Pangong So Lake. It is quite a famous lake. It's near Ladakh. Okay, it's in Ladakh. It's above Leh actually. And Dini Kinde, there's one more Somiriri. That is a, you know, wetland, Ramsar wetland. And Pangong So, you must be seeing in many movies, the scenic lake of Pangong So. If not, please Google it. It's a very scenic lake. So that is the background. And basically, ninna emaindante, as we have been seeing last few months nunchi, there is a border standoff between India and China. And the Chinese troops, they have carried out aggressive moves on the night of August 29th to change the status quo. And China is saying that Indian army has illegally crossed the line at 2 points near the Pangong Lake and near the Requin Mountain Pass. This is called Rezangla. So these names are important. Rezangla. This is basically near Requin Pass. Requin Mountain Pass. Okay. So PLA, they have violated antunnaru. And Indian position strengthen avutunnaru toward the Chinese intentions of unilaterally changing facts. And ninna ochina latest news entante ee article lo velindi, there is heavy firing between India and China. It has started. And the brigade commander level flag meeting was held at Chushul, this is also an important place, to resolve the issue. And it was committed for maintaining peace and tranquility through dialogue, but also equally determined to protect territorial integrity. And there is more news like saying they were told that there was no physical clash. And another source is saying that few hundred PLA troops climbed on the top of two mountains near Chushul and retreated later. Similarly, the PLA action is moving to South Bank as North Bank of Pangong has been secured. And it could be a diversion from Dipsang Plains. Anyway, in the ball-by-ball commentary, manaki examination point of view, it's not important. But please remember these names. Okay, they might be asking for math the following, where this was place stand, which is in which of the following places are seen in news recently, and questions are very generally asked. So Pangong Lake, of course, as I've showed you on the map, then Rekwin Mountain Pass, then Chushul, and Dipsang Plains. All of these are related to Ladakh. Okay. Next article we have is that GDP falls 23.9% in the first quarter. This is the worst contraction seen in decades. This is also part of headlines today. Indian economy has basically shrinking by a record of 23.9% in April to June quarter in comparison with same period last year. So ilanti quarterly comparisons eppudaithe vastayo, they are generally compared to last year. Ante 2020 lo April to June, deenni in comparison to 2019 lo April to June. So these are quarterly comparisons. Okay, both of these comparison lo 23.9% there has been contraction. So this is basically because of the lockdown, economic activities tagipay and slowdown trend started in the economy. Slowdown was actually there before the COVID-19 also. So danni inka exacerbate chesindi. And the economists, they expect that this contribution, which may be the worst in the history of independent India. So Indian economy is a deeply vicious cycle where demand is contracting so heavily, while the capacity to neutralize this contraction is also contracted equally because of tax revenue contraction. And this is told by the chief policy advisor, D.K. Srivastava. And he's basically also the advisory council member of the 15th Finance Commission. And he expects GDP to contract 5 to 7% in 2020-21. Okay. And last contraction in the range la indi was in 1979-80. 5.2% ayyindi appudu. And ivannitlo, agriculture was the only sector which recorded a modest growth, 3.4%. This is important. All otherlo, we have been seeing a contraction like 50% in construction, hotels, ivannitlo 47% contraction ayyindi. Manufacturing sector lo 39%, mining quarry, all this 23%, ivanni tagi. But agriculture lo 3.4%, there has been a growth. And do you know why this has happened? So if you've been following our classes regularly, you would be knowing that 3.4% is mainly because of, there was a lengthy article on this, that after the reverse migration, due to the reverse migration, migrant laborers evaraithe unnaro, for example, UP, Bihar nunchi, or Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, ilanti states nunchi, when they migrate to cities like Delhi, Bombay, Hyderabad, Bangalore, ippudu because of the lockdown, they have come back to their own villages. And villages ochi, they have taken up agriculture. So dani valla, there is a growth in agriculture. Okay, also on this, there might be a question asked. So please be aware of it. And the major burden on economy is the contraction you are seeing in private final consumption, which has weight of 60% in GDP. So demand valla, 60% GDP would be affected. And investment outlook also is very weak. And similarly, there is more analysis on it. But you should know 23.9% from this article and 3.4% as agreed. All right. And some other, see, like there is a lot of, like over the last few weeks, we've been seeing several estimates. World Bank nunchi, IMF nunchi, ela padutundi ani. Ikkada the chief advisor is saying that 5 to 7%. And another, Mr. Economist Pranab Sen, he's saying that 10 to 12% return annual GDP low. So let us see, that is not a very important issue now. You should just know in the first quarter, Matram, National Statistical Office, since it's official statistical information, National Statistical Office has told 23.9% contraction last year. Okay. All right. The next is, so finally, the contempt of court case of Mr. Prashant Bhushan, some closure we are able to see here. Right. That Supreme Court has imposed 1 rupee fine, nominal fine, for scandalizing the court. So instead of imposing a significant punishment, we are sentencing the condemner to nominal fee of 1 rupee. Mr. Arvind Mishra bench, they have told. And Prashant Bhushan is still saying that he reserved his right to file a review, but would pay the fine in an institution he holds in high esteem. So the court said an appropriate sentence and not a mere warning was required, as Mr. Bhushan has shown unjustified insistence to not express regret. So there is nothing much to discuss here. Like you can see, and the court also told that by September 15th, the 1 rupee he should pay, or else he should undergo a simple imprisonment of 3 months and a ban of practicing in Supreme Court for 3 years. And the court said it's up to the Apex Lawyers Body, Bar Council of India, to suspend the enrollment of the lawyer if it desires. So ilanti strong worded matram icharu, and the contempt of court case entirely we have discussed on 20th August. So if some of you have missed, please go back and watch it. We have done it at length. That is a very important issue, because last few weeks nunchi this has been continuing news. And finally, Supreme Court has told 1 rupee fine karte chalu. And kattak pote, there will be a ban of 3 months. All right. Okay, now let us come to the APPSC related news. As part of the first page, we have the Honorable Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy. He has ordered that a comprehensive survey of lands should be taken up across the state from Jan 1st, 2021. Okay, on the basis of Bhu Seva pilot project. Bhu Seva pilot project is teeskunnaru for land reforms and, you know, land surveying. For that, there should be a comprehensive survey of lands. So in review meeting on building a database for land transactions that is exhaustive and also tamper-proof, the CM has told that there should be rectifications made immediately and marking stones if any petaliani. And also the CM has told that there should be purification of the records. And deenvalla farmer problems tagutai, and mobile tribunals were proposed to be set up to redress farmers' grievances on the spot. Similarly, the CM instructed the officials concerned that the services rendered by sub-registrar should be made available in village secretariats. And this is a related news. This is not directly linked to the land records, because basically 52,000 cases were pending under revenue courts law. And a special drive is there to settle 79,000 cases. So basically nothing more, nothing much important here, but land reforms as such is very important for the APPSC, because it's one of the favorite topic. And in fact, in the previous syllabus, if you see the 2016 Mundu syllabus, appudu land reforms anedi AP economy lo, it was an entire part. If I remember correctly, it was part 2 of the AP economy. Land reforms in AP is unrelated. So land gurinchi even, please pay close attention. If there's some question related to land reforms, you should be able to mention of the Bhu Seva pilot project at Jagayapet in Krishna district, and how 2021 there will be a comprehensive survey of land records. That's it from this article. Next is, under the PM Swanidhi scheme, basically for vegetable sellers or alanti street vendors ki pettina Swanidhi scheme, dantlo Anantapur has stopped in AP for disbursing the loans. Here you can see the PM Street Vendor Atmanirbhar Nidhi scheme, funded by central government. The PM Swanidhi scheme is useful for street vendors and hawkers on the roadside. So the beneficiaries, they get 10,000 rupees from the district administration. And Anantapur district lo, with 76% targeted loans disbursed, it topped the 3 districts chosen in AP. And in all, 939 loans have been sanctioned and 93 lakh have been disbursed from the bank center. So you should just know that PM Swanidhi scheme, it's in news. and it is basically for street vendors. They get 10,000 rupees from the district administration. So it is a central government scheme. Okay, the next in APPSC news is that a rare Renati Chola era inscription has been found in Kadapa district. Like in the last year Group 1 prelims examination, there was a direct question asked that there was a Buddha statue. Buddha statue, Tavakallo, adi ekkada dorikindi ani oka question icharu. So similarly, such questions can be asked like a rare inscription dating back to Renati Chola. Idi Kadapa district lo it has been found. And it is engraved on a dolomite slab, which are part of fragmentary pillar excavated on the fields of B. Sivanarayan Reddy. So going by the language and characters, the inscription was written in archaic Telugu, which is readable in 25 lines. The first side with 11 lines and the remaining side with other side. And it was assigned to 8th century AD under the rule of Chola Maharaja of Renadu. Alright, so the inscription, it throws light on the record of gift of 6 martus. Martus anedi oka measuring unit gifted to a person, Siddhamayu, one of the Brahmins and so on. And they have contacted the director of epigraphy, ASI Mysuru, for assistance in deciphering this. And it says that the people who safeguard this inscription for future generations will acquire the status of conducting Ashwamedha Yaga. And those destroying it will incur the sin equivalent to causing a death in Varanasi. So ala rasarandi inscription lo. And the inscription has been shifted from the spot to be preserved in State Archaeological Museum in Gandikota project degara Jammala Maduku mandal lo pettar. Anyway, all this is not very important for us, but you should just know that Renati Chola inscription has been found in a remote village in Kadapa. Okay, inka detail ga kavalante Chinnaduyala village in Muddanur mandal Kadapalo it has been found. Okay, fine. So that APPS related, those are the news we had seen today, and now let us begin our discussion on the editorials of Hindu. The first big article in editorial is GST reforms needs a new grand bargain. So before starting this article, I wanted to have a quick revision of, you know, what is GST and what is a GST compensation. Edaithe article at length they have discussed, that you should be aware of it. So as you know, in the not First Amendment Act, GST introduced chesaru India lo. So GST basically, it conferred concurrent taxing powers upon parliament and state legislatures to make laws for levying GST on transaction of goods or services or both. So the GST basically replaced a number of indirect taxes, and it is to remove the cascading effect of taxes and provide a common national market for goods and services. Okay. These are the objectives of GST, which you must be aware of. Now, the important part is there is also a GST Compensation to States Act 2017. This is a statutory act. Many aspirants are not thorough with this, so I thought you should revise it here. And under the GST Compensation Act, GST Council, which is headed by the Finance Minister, and the Minister of State for Finance, both of these, they have basically 1/3 voting power, and all finance ministers of state or their representatives, they have 2/3 voting power. So ilante oka constitutional body form chesaru GST Council ani. And by the GST Council, I'm sorry, the ilante body form chesaru GST Council, and it has recommended that the union government should impose GST compensation cess on specified luxury and demerit goods. Okay. So e compensation cess anedi, it is for example, pan masala, tobacco products, or aerated water and caffeinated beverages between 12%, and coal penna 400 rupee per ton, అలాగే మోటార్ వెహికల్స్ ఎయిర్ క్రాఫ్ట్ యాట్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ 3 నుంచి 22% వరకు దెర్ ఇస్ సమ్ జిఎస్టీ కంపెన్సేషన్ అండ్ ద సెస్ కలెక్టెడ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ యూస్ ఫర్ కంపెన్సేటింగ్ స్టేట్స్ ఫర్ దర్ రెవెన్యూ లాసెస్ అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో ఫర్ ద ఫస్ట్ 5 ఇయర్స్ సిన్స్ ద ఇన్సెప్షన్ ఆఫ్ జిఎస్టీ బేసికలీ 2022 తక్ అండ్ ద ఫార్ములా యూజెస్ 2015 to 2016 as a base year. And it assumes 14% annual growth in the VAT system. So in the less state if they get their SGST, you know, 2015 the compared to from the VAT system, and the compensation is there. And it is basically imposed on luxury or demerit goods. Okay, this much is important. So recently, also one more thing you should know is recently the finance minister, Mrs. Nirmala Sitharaman, she had told that GST shortfalls 14% growth in the GST revenues because COVID-19 is a force majeure. Force majeure and it is an act of God. Since ma chetullo led kavati, GST compensation ఇవ్వలేని పరిస్థితులు ఉన్నారు అండ్ 97,000 crores ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో దే కెన్ యాక్చువల్లీ బారో ఫ్రమ్ ఆర్బీఐ అని ద సెంట్రల్ ఫైనాన్స్ మినిస్టర్ షీ హాస్ టోల్డ్ నా ద ఆర్టికల్ అండ్ రీసెంట్ లాస్ట్ ఫ్యూ డేస్ నుంచి వీ హెన్ సీయింగ్ క్రిటిసిజం ఆన్ దోట్ అండ్ హియర్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ ప్రాపర్ ఆర్టికల్ అండ్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ పార్ట్ ఇస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ రిటన్ బై మిస్టర్ విజయ్ కేల్కర్ ఓకే హీ వాస్ అ ఫార్మర్ 13th ఫైనాన్స్ కమిషన్ మెంబర్ సారీ చైర్మన్ and Vijay Kelkar is actually very famous in the entire fiscal FRBM or in the fiscal borrowing or many committees have been formed, the Kelkar committee. So he himself has written, so this is a very important article. So please read this carefully. Now, 3 years ago, the center and state, they struck a grand bargain, 2017, which we saw in the GST era. And the states gave up their right to collect sales tax and sundry taxes and center gave up excise and service tax. And there was, they promised that there should be a frictionless commerce across state, buoyant and leak-proof tax compliance, removal of tax inefficiencies, and tax on tax. There was a promise. And the consent was secured by a promise of reimbursing any shortfall in tax revenue for 5 years. This is the GST compensation system, which we just discussed. And the promised reimbursement was to fill the gap for assured 14% year-on-year tax growth for 5 years. Okay? 14% year-on-year tax growth. We have seen 2015, 14% annual growth VAT system low it assumed. Now the problem is neither the national aggregate nor any major states have the record for previous 5 years. But that was not the fault with the design, which had failed to learn from successful design of harmonizing VAT across national. The design also had reimbursement formula. So as economy battles a pandemic and recession, the tax collection has dropped significantly, as we have seen. But it seems that the states have been told that they are on their own to meet the shortfall of revenue. Because the finance minister, she used a force majeure clause in commercial contracts, and the center is abdicating the responsibility of making up for shortfall of 14% growth in GST revenues. So this 14% edaithe undo, it would not be met any, the center has told. Now the criticism begins. The problem is the states do not have recourse to multiple options like issue of sovereign bond. ఇప్పుడు స్టేట్ ఏదైతే ఉందో ఇట్ కెన్ ఇష్యూ సావరెన్ బాండ్ ఆర్ అ లోన్ అగేన్స్ట్ పబ్లిక్ సెక్టర్ యూనిట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద రిజర్వ్ బ్యాంక్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా సావరెన్ బాండ్స్ ఆర్ బేసికలీ లాంగ్ టర్మ్ బాండ్స్ గ్రేటర్ దెన్ 1 ఇయర్ ఓకే ఇట్ ఇస్ ఇష్యూడ్ బై ద గవర్నమెంట్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ యునో సమ్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ లైక్ టీబిల్ సిఎంబి ఇలాంటివి కూడా ఉన్నాయి దీస్ ఆర్ షార్ట్ టర్మ్ Like T-bill is, it can be, you know, different types of T-bills are there, but all of these, the CMB is 90 days, and all of these long-term bonds, sovereign bonds, they're greater than 1 year. సో ఇలాగ సెంటర్ కెన్ గివ్ సమ్ సావరిన్ బాండ్స్ అండ్ అలాగే సెంటర్ కెన్ కమాండ్ మచ్ లోవర్ రేట్స్ ఆఫ్ బారోయింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ మార్కెట్ అండ్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ అగ్రిగేట్ పబ్లిక్ సెక్టర్ బారోయింగ్ ఇట్ డస్ నాట్ మ్యాటర్ ఫర్ ద డెట్ మార్కెట్స్ నాట్ ద రేటింగ్ ఏజెన్సీ అండ్ ఫైటింగ్ ద రిసెషన్ త్రూ ఇంక్రీస్ ఫిస్కల్ స్టిమ్యులస్ ఇస్ బేసికలీ జాబ్ ఆఫ్ మ్యాక్రో ఎకనామిక్ స్టెబిలైజేషన్ విచ్ ఇస్ సెంటర్స్ డొమైన్ అండ్ మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్లీ బ్రేకింగ్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ ప్రామిస్ ఆఫ్ యూజింగ్ ద కంపెన్సేషన్ causes a serious dent in trust. So all of these reasons I have told. Like center anedi ipudu center ki emaina shortfall undanukondi adi ilanti long term bonds issue cheyochu or lower rate lo borrow cheskochu or public sector units ni it can use for debt markets fiscal stimulus ivvachu. So all of these options are there with the center, but states don't have such options. That is the problem. అండ్ ఇవన్నిటి మధ్య చిక్కుకుపోయింది ఇస్ కోఆపరేటివ్ ఫెడరలిజం. కోఆపరేటివ్ ఫెడరలిజం అనేది ఇట్ ఇస్ ద రిపీటెడ్ గేమ్ బిట్వీన్ టూ ఎంటిటీస్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ యాక్షన్ మస్ట్ థింక్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్యూచర్ కాన్సిక్వెన్సెస్. నా కౌతల్య హ్యాస్ ఆల్సో టోల్డ్ దట్ ఇలాంటి సావరిన్ అగెన్స్ట్ రీనేజింగ్ ఆన్ ద ఎనీవే ఇట్స్ నాట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ హీస్ సేయింగ్ దట్ కౌతల్య ఎవరైతే పొలిటికల్ థింకర్ ఉండేవారు ఎన్షియన్ టైంలో అతను కూడా ఇలాంటిది చెప్పేవారు. Against reneging the promise bailout as fulfilling the obligation which helps the trust between sub-sovereigns. So trust agutund antunnaru. And there is a comparison with Australia, which is not important for us. And here you can come back. After 28 years of 73rd and 74th Amendment, the local government do not have the promised transfer of funds, functions and functionaries. ఈ లోకల్ గవర్నమెంట్స్లో కూడా ఆఫ్ ద 12% జిఎస్టీ 10% షుడ్ బి షేర్డ్ ఈక్వలీ బిట్వీన్ స్టేట్స్ అండ్ సెంటర్ అండ్ 2% అనేది లోకల్ బాడీస్కి ఇవ్వాలి. అండ్ ద యాక్చువల్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్ అక్రాస్ పంచాయత్స్ డిస్ట్రిక్ట్స్ అండ్ సిటీస్ వుడ్ బి గివెన్ టు ద రెస్పెక్టివ్ స్టేట్ ఫినాన్స్ కమిషన్స్. సో జిఎస్టీ కన్సంప్షన్ ట్యాక్స్ పేడ్ బై ఎవ్రీ సిటిజన్ ఇట్ ఎస్టాబ్లిషెస్ అ టైట్ లింక్ బిట్వీన్ ద గవర్నమెంట్ అండ్ ద గవర్నమెంట్ అండ్ ద క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ గవర్నెన్స్ కూడా ఇంప్రూవ్ అవుతుంది. Right? So that is the basic gist of the article. 14% year-on-year growth was promised in the GST Compensation Act. And this has been taken back by the center recently by the Act of God clause. And deenivalla, there are a lot of problems. So the author, they give them some way forward, like federal democracy is low, there should be harmonization. And even local governments, they should be funds given. And as a way forward, they're telling that there should be an overhaul of the interstate GST with administration of e-way bill. Like some research papers, they show that the invalla it reduces the transaction cost. E-way bill valla. But the current system is too complex. We need a zero tax rate exports because GST is crucial for long-term structural reforms. And it can strike the right and desired balance to achieve cooperative federalism and lead to enhanced economic growth. So a new grand bargain is required. All right. So I hope you got a good idea from this article. You can use it in cooperative federalism because actually under federalism, the financial relations are very poor in India. So all these factors, you can focus on that. And the next important article from the editorial page is that environment is a national issue. Now, Mr. Jayanti Natarajan, she was actually a previous environment minister. So she says that environment issues are currently at the center of heated debate because draft EIA rules, which is actually not important for us to mug up because it's still in draft stage and I'm sure a lot of changes would come in the final EIA rules. So vatlo, you can see here, there was here somewhere that draft environment rules valla, how it can, you know, have a easier compliance by industries and easily valla clearance ivadam jarugutundo. That is a problem here ani they're saying. And deen valla, the winter pollution in North India also could be affected any, the political cellist told. Basically, the gist of the article is, environment is a very important national issue and ilanti environment should not be in political dissonance. and highlight it should highlight critical facts which need to be flagged for public knowledge. For example, if you see the environmental performance index, okay, under the EPI index, it is basically developed by Yale and Columbia in collaboration with WEF and European Commission. It shows that India was 118 rank in 2006 and 123, 155, but presently 177th among 180 countries in 2018. And in June 2020, India's rank stands improved at 168. Okay. Ippudu 168 koncham improve ayyindi antunnaru. And the experts, they conclude that the 2008 ranking suggests wealth is a major determinant for environmental success. And the environment cited by Gandhi, she told that there's a drop of 37 points. But the problem is, ilanti political issues, so it shouldn't be stuck. Like the charge ignores the record of UPA governments also, when important GOM committees were set up for ease of doing business as a special monitoring cell. And every government faces this balancing challenge. Because undoubtedly, if you see, we have problems like stubble burning, public usage pollution, and big industry with a polluting environment. This cannot be taken as a complete problem from the government. Because UPA government kuda, it was unable to frame subordinate legislation and implement the Forest Rights Act successfully. And there was a dilution of the Forest Rights Act antunnaru appatlo. Because forest is a state subject until it was transferred to the concurrent list by the 42nd Amendment Act. However, de facto powers of the state government continue regardless of the political affiliation. State governments hesitate to fully implement the Forest Rights Act. And deforestation should be a primary concern of any right-thinking government. So forest clearances for mining and industries are not the only causes for deforestation. Even jhumming, slash and burn agriculture, which takes place in the northeast, there is a severe reduction in the forest area. And there is a creeping conversion of forest to cultivated lands. And diversion of forests for mining and industry is regulated by law and courts. So, Ms. Jayanti Natarajan, she says that generally on deforestation, we can add this, you know, under the AP economy or under the group 4 deforestation, forest resources clearly unnayo, you can actually quote, as Mrs. Jayanti Natarajan, former Union Environment Minister, she has told that not only forest clearances for mining and industries, this is basically part of the draft EIA rules contention. Ive kaakunda jhumming edaithe chestunnaru and conversion of forest land to cultivated land. So improper cultivation and conversion to cultivation. Ilantivi kuda, there is a very fallen forest ani antunnaru. Alage Nirmal Ganga, it can be achieved by zero discharge of effective effluents and domestic wastage. But Aviral Ganga can only be achieved by constant balancing between irrigation needs of agriculture and potable water for cities and environmental flow of river and other. So Nirmal Ganga needs zero discharge. Aviral Ganga and Ganga should be properly flowing, continuously flowing. So to address environmental protection from standpoint of ideological or political molding is wrong because it is a national issue. And deento we need unwavering participation of all governments and citizens. Alright. So if there are some problems for you understanding this article, it's obviously a political article because there's a political kneel to it. That but recently Sonia Gandhi, she had written an article that environmental rules, draft EIA rules, dento meeru mining and industry ki easy clearance istunnaru, danni tiragrayalani annaru. And this article lo they're saying that fine tiragrayali, but dinni political point la cheyakoddu because environment EPI index is presently 168 among almost I think 180 countries. And other vidanga, the EIA draft lo there are problems, but other problems like stubble burning, public usage, and deforestation, ilanti problems kuda are crucial. నిర్మల్ గంగా విరల్ గంగాతో ఎలా గంగా క్లీనింగ్ కెన్ బి డన్ ఆల్సో ఇట్ ఇస్ సేమ్ అండ్ ఐ ఫీల్ ఫర్ ఫ్రమ్ అ ప్రిలిమ్స్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూ మోర్ సో దిస్ ఆర్టికల్ ఇస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఓకే ప్లీజ్ రిమెంబర్ ఈపీఐ ఇండెక్స్ ఇట్ ఇస్ బై టూ యుఎస్ యూనివర్సిటీస్ యేల్ అండ్ కొలంబియా ఇన్ కొలాబరేషన్ విత్ వరల్డ్ ఎకనామిక్ ఫోరం అండ్ యూరోపియన్ కమిషన్ ఇస్ ద మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ఆర్టికల్ సో నెక్స్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ Under more national news, presently 1,000 square kilometers is under China. Stretches along LAC are in PLA hands amid mobilization. Some about 1,000 square kilometers in Ladakh is now under Chinese control. China has been amassing troops and fortifying the presence along LAC since April to May. 20 soldiers were killed on June 15th and violent clashes are here. Official reveal that Debsang planes, which we saw, from patrolling point 10 to 13, and the scale of Chinese control stood at 900 square kilometers. So these areas are important. Galwan Valley. Galwan Valley is also along LAC, which we saw. All right. గల్వాన్ వ్యాలీ క్లాషెస్ లద్దాఖ్ దగ్గర ఏదైతే అయ్యో అండ్ హాట్ స్ప్రింగ్స్ ఏరియా పాంగాంగ్ సో అండ్ చుషుల్ ఆల్ దీస్ ఏరియాస్ ఆర్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ దట్స్ ఇట్ అండ్ యాజ్ పర్ ద అగ్రిమెంట్ ఇండియన్ ట్రూప్స్ ఆల్సో మూవ్డ్ బ్యాక్ ఫ్రమ్ దర్ ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్ పొజిషన్స్ లీడింగ్ టు క్రియేషన్ ఆఫ్ బఫర్ జోన్స్ అండ్ చైనీస్ ఫోర్సెస్ దే ఆర్ ఆక్యుపైయింగ్ అ కన్సిడరబుల్ ఏరియా ఫ్రమ్ ఫింగర్ 4 టు ఫింగర్ 8 near Pangong So Lake. So Pangong So Lake ki basically it is something like ilanti. Okay, and veetni finger center. And 4 to 8 daggara Chinese has occupied. All right. And this another article related to the India China issue. Our External Affairs Minister Mr. S. Jaishankar, he has called for modus vivendi, that is agreement to coexist between two Asian powers. So basically, he is told that the provocative attempt by Chinese troops, which we discussed in the first article, who made no reference to the ongoing tensions between two countries, saying India remains cognizant of China's rise. So if you have two countries, two societies, and billion people each, it is very important to reach a kind of understanding because it is a practical world. So there is need of realism in India-China relations. Basically, the author recently, he has written the book, The India Way. India Way book, it's written by S. Jaishankar. It can be asked for competitive examinations. So please remember it. And our booklo, he is saying that we are going to see activities and capabilities we have not seen before. We see from China and some other areas, they will see it from us. So ilanti modus vivendi edaithe undo, it is very consequential for both countries and rest of the world. And if India's challenge from China's aggressive behavior, deeni valla, will there be more closeness with US? As well as signing more defense agreements, foundational agreements, and quad. Quad is basically between four countries, US, India, Japan, and Australia. So this is a grouping, and 2008, actually they've been asking for this grouping, and recently also there are talks of strengthening this. And alage 2+2 dialogue related to one country kaadantunnaru. Now, deeniki Mr. S. Jaishankar has told that India-US ties are not tailored to one situation or focus on one country. That's not a short-term issue. So, India and US coming together is in many ways, and our interests are so similar in many domains. So, India-US defense ties unnai. If US businesses choose to invest in Indian manufacturing, where government has announced import ban on 101 items. Similarly, pointing to more flexible investment rules, he said Indian defense has a great opportunity. In India and US, they enjoy a level of political trust which didn't exist in the past. So the gist is basically that India-US are separate relations. It's not focused on a country, China. US has a separate policy. They have their pivot to China policy. So dantlo idu pettlem manam. This is basically for our own interests. We have many interests and US business, they choose to invest in Indian manufacturing. Okay, and similarly, defense agreements. All this can be part of India-US relations. And the last article for today is, as we have seen, there is a 23.9% contraction in the economy. So the RBI has announced that there will be more liquidity measures amid rising yields on government securities and concern for higher borrowing. So it would conduct additional special open market operations to ensure the market conditions. So the open market operations chestaru, where there will be a proper buying of the securities chesi, there will be a more liquidity in the market chestaru ani antunnaru. And that would be almost 20,000 crore in two tranches of 10,000 crore each on September 10th and September 17th. So huge open market operations transactions are going to be done. And the central bank came when, after the biggest contraction in the, and the central's fiscal deficit has exceeded 100% budget target. So RBI will basically, they will hold this open market operations to increase the liquidity in the market. And it will also conduct repo operations for aggregate amount of 1 lakh crore at floating rates. So repo operations, they will take it up. And the RBI assured the borrowing program of center and states would be completed in a non-disruptive manner. Since we are seeing food and fuel prices are stabilizing and cost push factors are moderating, so a non-disruptive manner will be taken up. This is the RBI's response basically to the contraction. All right. And this is basically, I wanted to revise the concept in banking you study, when inflation unnapudu or when there's a contraction in economy unnapudu, how you deal with it. So since ikkada there is a contraction, there should be ease of liquidity, and RBI ikkada, it will do that. It will have a purchase and sale of government securities for 20,000 crore. So, and something like Operation Twist. Operation Twist lo kuda, it's an open market operation to increase the liquidity. Okay. We shall be adding an article on Operation Twist in the description below. Please read through it. Okay. Since we are closing on the 45 minutes limit we have. And there are two sample mains questions here for you today. Do you think that the cooperative federalism exists in India in financial relations? Critically examine. So it is basically the lengthy editorial article which you have seen. So you should, since it has asked for examination, factual analysis le evali. Federalism and ante federalism, cooperative federalism ela untundi, states and centers madhyalo. And adhe vidhanga asal federalism lo there are three parts. The administrative, legislative, and financial. And financial relations lo the fiscal, the federalism is very poor in India. That is a known fact. So if you critically examine, there is a problem as such. You should just be aware of your criticism. It's not unwarranted by supporting with the facts. Like put force majeure clause ila pettaru. And GST compensation says 14% evolves in the how there'll be a shortfall. So all these you should focus on. So cooperative federalism on constitution, in constitution, we have GST council. We have finance commission. So ilanti unnai manaku financial relations lo, but off late, there are issues of this and how the way forward ela cheyali. So trust penchali. Alage local government, local self-governments ki funding undali. So ilanti aspects you should focus on. The next is, would India's challenge to China's aggression result in strategic closeness to USA? So this was basically discussed by our external affairs minister. Like how Chinese aggression, like USA, so you could analyze kabatti, you should take a fact by fact analysis. And the chemistry lo analysis ela chestaru. అలా. సో ఫస్ట్ ఇండియా చైనా రిలేషన్స్ యూ షుడ్ సి ద అగ్రెషన్ అండ్ హౌ బార్డర్లో ఎలా వైలెంట్ క్లాషెస్ హ్యావ్ టేకెన్ ప్లేస్. అలాగే ఇండియా యుఎస్ యూ షుడ్ సి సెపరేట్లీ అండ్ యూ షుడ్ గివ్ అ కంక్లూజన్ దట్ బోత్ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్. లైక్ ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ ద క్వాడ్ అండ్ అదర్ 2+2 డైలాగ్, ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ దే ఆర్ లుకింగ్ దట్ దే ఆర్ ఎయిమ్డ్ ఎట్ చైనా, బట్ బోత్ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్ రిలేషన్స్ బికాస్ ఇండియా యుఎస్ హ్యాస్ ఫార్ మోర్ డిఫరెంట్ ramifications, like in area of manufacturing or in area of strategic interests or, you know, nuclear fuel or NSG entrance. Even in areas like USA closeness would be there. Of course, there might be some meeting points, but you shouldn't see it in that relation. Okay. So please write these two answers. I think this you can write for 250 words for 15 marks. And this you can write for 150 words for 10 marks. And please submit your answers by 5 p.m. Please, me late cheyakandi, more than 5 p.m. 5 p.m. deadline and pettukoni cheyandi, because the faculty evaraithe unnaro vallaki the papers they have given after 5 o'clock. So 5 varaku ochinavi malli meer 7 dan tarvata pampiste there are issues. Like 5 to 6, 5 to 7 they are able to correct and they are able to give you back. So if you send it late, and again we are needing to ask them, so there is a problem. So since hardly meeku 20 minutes lo, you should be able to write both of these. So 5 p.m. lopo I'm sure 20 minutes you can find. So please write and submit and make use of this initiative. So if you like today's discussion, please like, share and subscribe, and soon we shall have live classes where we shall cover the group 1 material also, and daniki we need 1000 subscriptions from your end. So please be a part of Itaragati and take full use of the courses we are offering. So all the best, study well, and we'll meet tomorrow. Bye.